It has a lot to do with it.
If because a man just wanted to hit it, he would wait 6 months and just hit it and then roll up.
That's what they've been
give
doing.
It, he ain't got nothing
Where
to do
have
with
you
it.
Been?
I'm telling you from, let me get, I can give you some secrets about men.
Okay, tell me.
I can give you something. What, we don't want it too quick, but we don't want you to take too long to give it. If you give it too quick, you ain't gonna mean nothing to us. But if you take too long to give it, you become now, you just a quest. You just a trophy for our mental peace. When we done hit it, we gone.
Okay, but then why not establish that in the beginning? Because I may be the woman who want to just give it to you and you roll out.
But because
set the boundaries at the beginning.
You, because you seem to be
Don't
so
make decisions
holy, holy.
For me.
Because you seem to be so holy, holy, and you making this whole relationship thing a challenge. The man is just going to accept you as a challenge. And when he didn't conquer that challenge, he lose interest in it.
And you know what? I feel as if that should not be one of the most important things in a relationship.
But
why
is,
are you thinking about
it? It is for me.
Okay.
The sex is be the ultimate goal. I meet a girl, I may date her, we may go, but at the end, the at the end of the line, Utah want that. I want it. I don't care how long it take or when. I want it. Don't tell me I ain't in a relationship and I ain't interested in sex.
We're not saying that you're not interested in sex, but what you have to realize, it is very important in a relationship. But understand, when you have sex too early, here's what the problem is, okay? With women, we are receptors. We receive. Men are projectors.
Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah.
And with a woman, okay, 9 times out of 10, she's the one who's left in the cold wondering, oh God, why did he hurt me? This, that, and the other, da, 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 da. I done gave him my cookies and he did that to me. Okay? So for you, it may not be that important, but for a woman, it is. Okay? And this is where I said that's the communication, where communication comes in. If you're not interested in her like that, okay, why not just say, listen.
But it don't start up like that, Erica. Okay, I looking at three beautiful ladies, right? I don't know y'all personally, right? The first thing in my mind, well, ain't none of y'all wearing nothing sexually revealing that could set me directly on sex. Ain't none of y'all dressed that sort of way. So when I'm thinking about sex, I'm thinking about, hey, I could go maybe have a nice evening with one of these young ladies and maybe get lucky. It's still in my mind to think maybe I might get lucky, but that ain't the first thing. So my thing is, you know.
So then how can you get an ABC if that's what you're always thinking about?
Well, see, it's what the eyes is what the eyes behold. It ain't me. I'm sorry, like I
no, but you said you were a man. I understand what you're saying.
Ambition, beauty, and class.
And a classy woman doesn't give it to a man right away.
No. Understand a man now. He ain't looking at class that way. Look at Nakira. Okay. She didn't get the memo that this was going to be a casual show. You're just supposed to dress casual, right? But she is sexy. She's wearing a nice dress. She's wearing pantyhose. Man, look at pantyhose are sexy. Man loves a woman wearing pantyhose and heels, right? So, we look at her. She may not even have a job. She may not own a car or whatever, but just looking at her now, she looks classy. This is a classy woman, you know? So, if she's classy, we think perhaps she is ambitious. So we go on this date. I ain't going to take Nakira. Hold on, studio audience. I ain't going to take Nakira to Kentucky. If I want to go on a date with Nakira, I'm going to probably take her to Villaggio, Luciano's, or East Willis. Because she looks classy. But she don't have to be classy.
No.
She just has the look. So as we sit down over dinner and I talk and we have a conversation and then I find out this is a dumb bimbo, all I want to do is hit it and just go.
Okay.
But even with the classy ladies, that's the same prognosis that you guys may have. You just probably want to hit it because you see somebody whose exterior is beautiful.
They won't lock that down. A man love prestige. A man loves prestige. And what I notice about a lot of my friends, the person who either is their main girlfriend or their wife is normally be the ugliest person I ever saw them date. But she is classy. She has prestige. And she is someone who they proud to say, this is my girl or this is my wife. It don't have to do with the looks when it comes to when someone is choosing someone for that wife or the main girl character, you see. I just use that as an example. You know, but she's going to be classy. This is going to be someone who he can treat her with respect.
Because she has brains.
But my question is, so exactly what is it that you want? You know, because you said if we take too long.
Okay, I can tell you what.
He gets one sec.
And then if you get it too. Okay,
ten.
So give us the ten rules.
You can expand on it in your book.
Now.
So give us the 10. What is the 10?
A man wants a woman who is going to cater to him. He wants to feel as if he is the lord of the castle. Hold on. Let me finish. he wants a woman who will cook. Every man want a woman who will cook. But he want a woman who's going to go. I once dated a girl, right? She know Utah loves steak and lobster and crab and rice. I can eat that every day repeatedly. And, you know, crab don't be in season all the time. This woman used to drive, she'll drive from Yamacraw to Lightfoot Key to find my food, right? And my present fiance, right? I know she could be upset that I said this. She said, why you didn't marry her, right? But I was like, at that, you know, it was marriage wasn't in the picture at that time, you know. But this woman, she catered to me, but she knew that I loved this particular food. And she went and she got that man. And that put her, she was exalted in my books. And that's one way. And then another way, as females, like you say, females are receivers. And females just love to lay back and receive. A man, you may find, you wonder why you're doing everything. You think you're doing everything for the man, but why you still going out there and scheming? A man was designed different. A man needs, most of the guys who will scheme, they just, every now and again, boy, I shouldn't share these secrets. But it's happened. Every now and again, a man, and I talk this with male friends, they get a craving for something new. It ain't that they love the girl that they with. It ain't that they won't be with her. It ain't that they won't do this. But this power has just come over them, and they just want something new. So they just go there and just hit something off new and just come back. Now, sometimes they just get caught up because the little hit off that they do tend to cater to them. But this is how this could be prevented. Creativity. Vehement females do not know the definition of creativity. You gotta be different. And when you be different, that will be categorized as new.
But you're talking only about the vehement women. What about you? What about the vehement guys? They're no better than
us. Because you have yet to say that the man has to communicate this. If I don't know that's what you like, you expect for me to read your mind and say, okay, this is, communicate that to your woman. Because a woman, I'm like this. I'll cook. Mm. But if I'm out working 9 to 5, just like how you're out working 9 to 5, and you get home before I do, I think it's sexy as hell if I come home and I meet the food on the table.
Right. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's good.
Thank you, girls. Thank you. That's sexy as hell.
That definitely is good, right? But let's just say, he don't do it. Not trying to put a role on a female, but based on biblical readings. I know you don't like when I go to my biblical readings. But based on biblical readings, as Christ is the head of the church, man is the head of the home. Man should provide.
And without the neck, the head can't turn.
Man should provide the grocery, and the woman should make it into food.
I disagree with that.
Therefore, one of her roles should be to cook the food. If the man feel like cooking the food, then yes, like you said, sexy for you to come home and make the food. But if he don't cook, it is your duty to come home and prepare that meal for your husband.
No. Hold on. What if I have a husband that does not mind? You know what, baby? Mm. You don't have to cook. I like to cook. What if we communicated, because you're leaving this out again?
No, but
this is what, that's to me one of the biggest issues in a relationship, the lack of communication.
Right.
You want it 3 times a week, but baby, I can't go 3 times a week. Well, you know what, how can we come to the middle?
Well, that's okay. I just, now you're making a lot of sense, right? You're making 100% sense, but I'm trying to tell you the way the male, don't forget now, the male is designed different from the female. I'm telling you how behemoth males think. I just give you the tip. We like something new. Mm-hmm. I don't have to come to you and say, baby, why don't you get a hotel room, put some roses on the bed, get some scented oil, and let's make love. I want you to just do that. Surprise me.
No, but wait a minute.
Surprise me, sweet girl.
Some men may not like that. What I'm saying to you is, are you a mind reader?
No.
Are you a mind reader? And I'm certainly not a mind reader. Like I said, in the beginning of the relationship, before you're talking about, oh, you know, the sex and all of that, why can't we not have a conversation about what it is that I expect mm-hmm. and what you expect in a relationship. What? You know what, baby? I like something new. I like to be excited. I want to try new different things. Like what? But